Hi, I'm Kira McKee, and this is another video about giving scientific presentations. Most of us plan our scientific talks the same way we write our technical papers. We use the typical paper format of introduction, methods, results, and conclusions in that order to design our seminars and conference presentations. This approach is the one that is expected by a technical audience and that the presenter usually finds most logical and convenient. We simply follow in a linear fashion each step we took in conceiving and conducting the study. Some would argue that a traditional format is the only acceptable way to give a formal talk about scientific research. Anything else is unprofessional. I would like to play devil's advocate here for a moment and consider whether this viewpoint is totally justified or if there is another approach that might work better, and that is to tell a story. This idea is not a new one. Many experts advise speakers that the best way to capture and hold an audience's attention is to tell a story. The idea of storytelling as a professional presentation device has become fairly widespread in business circles, maybe even to the point of attaining myth status, hence my title. Audiences love stories, presumably even audiences composed of scientists. We enjoy a good story just as much as regular folks. But should we use a story to present scientific information? What kind of story are we talking about? Let's explore the idea a bit. A good story can help a speaker connect with the audience and can help the audience understand the content of the presentation. In a scientific presentation, we are presenting facts and figures for the most part. I'm sure there are scientists out there who want to present only the facts and sneer at the suggestion that those facts might be presented in the form of a story. You've probably heard such speakers. They jump right into their talk without providing any background or stopping to explain complex concepts or terminology. They assume that the audience understands why their research is important. If someone in the audience is not up to speed, then too bad. This example sits at one extreme along a continuum in the connection between speaker and audience. At the other extreme is the situation in which the speaker has made not only an intellectual connection with the audience, but an emotional one as well. This is where storytelling comes in. Its purpose is to enhance the connection between speaker and audience. A story will elicit some type of emotional reaction: surprise, intrigue, laughter, curiosity, excitement. The idea is to capture the audience's attention right from the beginning and make them pay attention through to the end. I don't think it requires much of a change in traditional format to turn what could be a boring presentation into one that will make the audience sit up and pay attention. There are a few ways to do this. Some presenters, in a sentence or two, explain how they became interested in their topic or what their motivation was. Other speakers spark the audience's curiosity by posing the work in the form of a broader question or a deeper mystery. A speaker might even combine the mystery and personal story approaches by starting a presentation this way. I was at my field site finishing up measurements and made an interesting observation. I wondered what was going on, so I decided to conduct a little side experiment. The results of that experiment turned out to be the most important discovery of my career. Now you've got the audience's attention. They will want to hear how the story turns out. Here are a few more openers. In this talk, I'll describe an experiment that led to the most surprising conclusion about insert your research topic. Or, that experiment led me to the most interesting aspect of my dissertation research. Or, the study I'll be talking about today led me to question my whole approach to insert science topic. Then you can proceed with a typical format of introduction, methods, results, and conclusions to describe your study. At the end, you would return to your story and perhaps explain how this has led you into an exciting new area of research or to new research collaborations. You can also tell a story by putting your research into a historical perspective as part of your introduction. Describe how previous discoveries or insights have led up to your question or hypothesis. The audience will then wonder how your story will turn out. Will your work add to that history? Will it overturn long-held dogma? Audiences always appreciate having things put into a historical perspective, especially those who contributed to that history. Another way to tell a story in your introduction is to present what is known and what is not known about your topic, and then explain how your research attempts to fill that information gap. You can use facts and figures to support your story, but it will still be a story. How will it turn out? Will your data be sufficient to bridge the gap, or will more work need to be done? Most audiences will find such approaches not only acceptable, but will remember your talk because you injected some emotion and creativity into it. So, does the advice about telling a good story extend to scientific presentations? Well, think about which presentations you've heard that really stuck with you. Did they tell a good story? Thanks for watching. And don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss something that may help you improve your scientific presenting and writing.